Also, side note, do you guys ever like love how clean the mirror is in your makeup palettes before like you start using it over and over again, and then all of a sudden it's not clean anymore? It's like the calm before the storm, where it's all like clean, and you know in a week it's gonna be smudged with all the different colors. Hello everyone, and welcome back to our channel. So my name is Nicole. I am the founder here of Epifania Magazine, and today I will be trying on the Selena makeup from MAC. So it is the Selena collection from MAC in honor of our Queen Selena for receiving a Lifetime Achievement Award at the Grammys. So I thought it would be a wonderful way to pay tribute to her by trying on her makeup line in collaboration with MAC that has been around for a while. So I'm trying it out for the first time. And you guys will see my review soon. But in the meantime, or actually, after you watch this video, make sure to click in the links in the description box below, so that way you guys can read our articles, because our team has grown in the last few months. I keep saying that, but I'm so proud of our team's growth. And you will also get to follow us on our other social media channels. So thank you guys all for being here, and I hope you enjoy this video and how I did this look with the Selena makeup line from MAC. All right, see you guys. I got their blow palette here and a lipstick. So let's actually open up the palette first. I did already use it once, but I put it back in the box. Open it up. It's like this. So you remove the little picture of her and the tissue. And then, like I said, I already used it, so it's a little messy, but these are the colors. And she has a few lipsticks. And due to shipping and quantity, I got a nude. I didn't get a red one, but I got a simple nude one. So it's just a nice little nude lipstick. But I like how it looks like the design of it. It's cute. It's very compact. And then you open, and there it is. And it's really cute because it has a little rose. I don't know if you guys can see the design there, but there is a design and it's a little rose. So let's play around with this. So I'm gonna do my eyeshadows first before I put on the rest of my face. So I'm actually going to go in with this color here. It's, in person it looks like a rose gold, but I think on camera it looks more gold. But it's this one right here. And I'm actually gonna put that over my eyelids. The other day I had it as a highlight, and I thought it would just look better to be over the eyelid and then do darker colors on top of it. So we'll see if that looks correct. It's also very sparkly and very light. So you're not gonna see a lot of difference in the beginning. It's exactly how I thought it was gonna look, because this eyeshadow, it's not very pigmented and it's like just sort of just glitter. So it's not gonna, it's just gonna add a little bit of spark, but if it was just like that, not too much. So we're gonna add some color. So we're gonna go in with this pink on the outside. You see how that looks? I don't have a lot of MAC products, to be honest. I think this is like the only MAC products I have. I'm not gonna lie, I really wish they did this partnership with like another company. Cause, it's MAC. It's like everyone and their mother uses it. Their makeup artists are dope though, I'm not gonna lie. Out of all like the store makeup artists, MAC makeup artists seem to be like more talented and just more creative. There's just a lot of like a mess. Like it's like too loose. The powder is like really loose. There we go. I can speak today. Alright, so I took a quick little break, went to the restroom and cleaned it up a bit because it kept like just getting messy. And it looks better in my bathroom mirror, so I'm trying not so hard to be hard on myself because it looks pretty good. I'm actually gonna do my eyebrows and then go back to the eyes, add a little bit more color, and then we'll do the rest of the face and then try on that lipstick. I absolutely love doing my eyebrows. The cool thing is I don't want to do too much because I have pretty thick eyebrows as it is. And so I just like that I get to like just give them a little bit more definition. And they just have more life. I don't know about you guys, but I definitely remember when Selena died. I wasn't like a avid listener of hers because when she died, I was 10. And so I wasn't listening to a lot of her music because I'm also third generation. So I wasn't listening to a lot of like Spanish music. My parents did. My parents really loved Tejano music because they both have Texas roots. But I do remember she died because I just remember my parents being sad. And it was one of the times I remember, this is how vivid the memory was. Story time. So we had bunk beds at the time. So me and my sister, we always shared a room I had my own room, but then as my younger brother got older, you know, it was better to put the girls together and then he could have his own space. Because let's be honest, like a preteen teenage boy, so it needs its own space, privacy. Okay. And so, but we had bunk beds and I remember being on the top bunk and my sister being on the bottom bunk, and we had a TV in our room and the TV faced the bunk beds. It was like here, the bunk beds were up against one wall and the TV was up against another wall. And I just remember the news being on and like being sort of shocked that we can watch the news like as kids, and my mom had it on while she was like putting us to bed, and it was just that was on, and just the sadness, and then especially just knowing because we were about to go to bed and my mom like was watching this as she put us to bed, that it had to be something of importance because we wouldn't be watching the news otherwise as kids. And then also just having a lot of like my aunts and my cousins being really sad, like putting her picture up on the wall next to like President Kennedy, to be honest. So it's like Selena and President Kennedy. But yeah, so knew it was important. And then when the movie came out in 97, that was like a staple in our home. Like everyone watched that movie. Like I think if you're Mexican American, you watch that. You watch like American Me, so there's a lot of movies. And I remember after watching that, just knowing how important she was and just also just being so sad, like the way she died. I think there's no other way to say it. I think everyone has said it. It's just a sad way to go. And that it could have been prevented, but you know, her legacy lives on. And then now with the new series, right? With the new series out on Netflix, which I know has some love and hate. I personally thought it was a good story. I thought the storyline that they wanted to tell, I thought was, you know, a way to show more of like the bigger picture of her life. But anyways, watching that series, I was like reminded, I'm like, holy fuck, she was really young. Like she was really in the beginning of her life, like, you know, getting on like the English album and just recently being married. That, I think that's what really hurt people, because I was like, just, dude, that's, things are supposed to be good at that time in your life. You know what I mean? Anyways, I'm using a different brush and I'm going to go like into the crest a little bit. But anyways, same color, same pink. It's just going to be pink, pink, pink. Oh, there we go. There we go, guys. Oh, yeah. I know, it looks like a lot, but I promise you in person, I don't look crazy. Okay, also, when I said I wish I didn't do a collaboration with MAC, it's because I'm trying my hardest to just buy clean beauty products or Latina-owned company products, and so I was like, this isn't clean, but you know, it's collaboration with a Latina, like, family, like artist family, so I'm like, okay. But do I wish it was with the clean beauty line? Most definitely. I just have to come to terms with the fact that my face is just going to have glitter on it today. Foundation is on. Now I'm just going to put on a little bit of blush. I'm actually going to go back and right under my eyebrow, I'm going to put more of this rose gold glitter, because apparently I just want more glitter on my face. I feel like it would just give it a little something, something. Oh yeah, you could definitely see that. All right, so now we are going to try on the MAC Selena lipstick, and I got the color Selena Viva. Yeah, I guess that's what the color is called. Yeah, Selena Viva, and it's a nude lipstick. So let me just put this on. Let me get my mirror so that I can put it on correctly. Now, it is a very nude lipstick. Nudes tend to not always be my favorite color, but this one I sort of like. I'm not gonna lie. It's MAC, so it goes on pretty matte. It's not a gloss. It stayed on for like one virtual 30-minute meeting. Like, it's not a lipstick that's gonna stay on, like, all day. Which, I guess, depends on what you're trying to do with your lipstick. Like, we're all doing virtual meetings and virtual, in my case, virtual workshops, like, leading them. So, I don't mind it not staying on the whole day because at the end of the day, I don't want to have to scrub my lips as well. I already have to scrub my face. So, just letting you know. So, if you really want a lipstick that stays on the whole day, might not be the one for you. Now, my quick little review, if you will, of the palette. The colors, again, here are the colors. And they are quite versatile in the sense that they have some really bold ones, like the pink one I'm using, that rose gold, and even that red, meaning if you really like to play up your eyes, you do have some color like to use. But they also have very neutral colors, like, you know, people that really love to just stay in the neutral. I'm not gonna give people shade, but you know, the boring lane, the neutral lane. They got some neutral colors here, some browns and a tan, like, and a beige. So you definitely could play around with all these different looks. So overall, I like the color selection. I don't like how this rose gold glitter one goes like everywhere. Like, the pink a little bit, but this rose gold is just like, whew, flies everywhere. All right, I hope you guys enjoyed that video. Make sure to subscribe, like, share, comment, all that good stuff, and we'll see you guys around. All right, bye.